Correct, and this is the fourth part of this chapter. We have completed the startup class in the previous tutorial. Let us now complete the index razor page as a part of this current tutorial. The ultimate objective is this page. This is the home page. This page has a heading and this page has a form. This form is connected to the table TBL teacher in our database. We have completed this table TBL teacher in one of the previous tutorials, and let me show you how we did it. For that, we have already done our teacher model. If you review, this is the project. Inside the project, we have the models folder, and there we have the teacher.cs. This class has our model for teacher, and inside this model, we have two properties. One is for email and one is for name. These are connected to the inputs of our homepage, the input boxes on the homepage that you saw just now. And we have added a few annotations also. This is, remember, for the primary key. This is for the required validator, that if the field is left empty, this is the error message that will be shown. We will be configuring this today. This is the display name. You will understand why is this. You will understand how to use this on the razor page. Just give me a moment. Similarly, for the name property, this is the same display. We will discuss in a moment. The max length attribute, the required, these are for validation. These will work on client side also and server side also, but I will be discussing only the server side validation, because client side validation with jQuery JavaScript, you can do it at your own level also. Let us start by adding the razor page. For that, come to your project. Create a folder called pages. Remember, all our razor pages must be inside a folder called pages. So we have created a folder called pages in our project. Now right click the pages folder to add a razor page for index. And we also know that a razor page is a pair of two files with the same name, index, but different extensions. This is a program file and this is the markup file. These two files, they form our index razor page. Let us first start by writing code into the razor page. If you double click to open, you will get your razor page. This is the razor page index.cshtml. This is the file that we are working now. Add page directive is required. This connects the model class, the backing class index model that we have discussed in so many of our previous lectures also. And this is the tag helper, which is required for the proper working of the input tags and the form elements. This also we have already done. So I have called it basic plumbing. Now, starting with this one, this is the heading register teacher. A pipe is there. Register teacher, see the extract I've shown here. This is that pipe. And this is the anchor helper for A, all teachers. This will take you to the page for the teachers. This page we have not added yet. This page will ultimately be added in the next lecture, and it will be used to show the list of all registered teachers. After that, we have written a form for the method post, and we have used a table for writing this form. You can have a look at how we have done this first form element, tr. This is the first form element. Input ASP for teacher.email. The teacher is our model property, the bind property. This is the bind property that we will make on the CS file. Just in a moment, I will add that property there. teacher.email. This is the input, this one. ASP validation for teacher.email style color red span. This is this part. This part will take the data, and this part will be used to display any validation errors. ASP.NET Core will automatically put any validation messages into the inner HTML of this pen. As you are seeing, email is required is a validation error that is appearing here. So this is how this will be used. Then you must also be seeing teacher.email, there is a label. This label, this text is appearing for this label, but I have not written this text anywhere. In fact, ASP.NET Core picks the text for this label from the display attribute. The display attribute for email we have applied name of the teacher. This you are seeing because by mistake we have shown for name here, or you can see it like this. The teacher.name, this will pick the name of the teacher. For the email, it was email ID of the teacher in the model that you can go and refer. So this label connects this display to this. You can control what appears on your form through this attribute. Name is required is the error message for the required property, and you can see this error message will appear here. This will be automatically fitted into the ASP validation for by the ASP.NET Core engine. All the three parts I will review. This is for the label picked from the display. This is the email connected to the input, and validation for will be used by ASP.NET Core to display this text into this one. After that, this is for the name input, the same story will go. And finally, this is the submit button that will take the data to your page. This is the simple markup for the index.cshtml razor page. Now let us come back to the Solution Explorer, find our project, and now let us write code into the index.cshtml.cs file. Let us open it and we will now complete this class. This is the index model class coming from the page model. Now I will explain the various parts of this code. First of all, this is the constructor, and DB context reaches our constructor. ASP.NET Core provides the DB context to us through our constructor, and we have saved it here. This we have already discussed in the database connectivity chapter. You can refer to that chapter for more detail. Then you see this bind property. This bind property for teacher connects this form to this property. When register button is clicked, the data for these two fields, it is available to us in this property. On post async is the method that will be called when the register button is clicked, the posted data will reach us. But the posted data may have some errors also. For example, if a user has left a field blank, in that case a validation problem should be there. So what we do is, here we check if not model state is valid. If it is not valid, return page. The processing will stop, no database entries will occur, the whole form will be sent back to the caller, but ASP.NET Core will automatically put the validation errors into the place where we marked ASP validation for in the razor page. We have discussed that just now. This is picked from name is required. This is the required. So if somebody has left it blank, a validation failure has occurred and this executes and the page is returned back. We have written return page so that the data already filled by the user, it stays, it is displayed. If things work out, we write context.teachers.add. The teacher is added, the data is added to the context, and then we call context.saveChanges async to save the data to the database. A database failure may occur. For example, if a duplicate entry is being tried, if a user is trying to register an email that is already there, some database exception may occur. So in that case, we must send a validation error back to the form. Let us see how we do. We have just assumed that the only validation error that is occurring is because of a primary key violation. So this is how I have done it. You can take your own cases as you do your practical projects. So let me now explain. If this fails, we will add a model error to teacher.email validator. Span ASP validation for teacher.email. This name should match this text. Type this text as matching this one. When you do this, the model error is artificially added and account already exists. This message is sent to the form and you can see account already exists. It will appear as the error here. In the next line, we have written remove teacher because the teacher that we added here will be removed and the page sent back so that the user can see the error what he has done and his data will be shown as such. But if things work, this succeeds, then we do not enter this catch, then we come redirect to page teachers and the user is taken to the teachers page where the list of all the teachers is shown to him. This is the form that you can study. This is the completed form. Let us run the project. When we run the project, you will see this form. Click here without filling anything. You will find that these validators are working. After that, type some email ID, type some name and try to register. When you click here, your data will be saved to the database and you will be taken to the register to the teachers page. So when I click this time, I will see a validation exception because the teachers page has not been yet added. In our next tutorial, we will add the teachers page and complete the rest of the project. Thank you.